Blackstone Publishing presents A People's History of Computing in the United States by Joy Lisi Rankin. This book is read by Bernadette Dunne. For Scott and Lucy. Introduction. People Computing, Not the Silicon Valley Mythology. The students at South Portland High School buzzed with enthusiasm. The wires in their classroom walls hummed with information. Young men and women played games on their computing network, tic-tac-toe and checkers, solitaire and bridge, basketball and bowling. They clamored for news from other schools on the network, which crisscrossed New England and connected rural Maine to suburban Connecticut. "Don't forget to sign me up for time," they reminded each other. Some of these notoriously difficult-to-rouse high schoolers even rolled out of bed at 4 a.m. for network access. 1,000 miles to the west, students and teachers in the Minneapolis suburbs spoke the same language. From the basic building blocks of commands including if, then, let, and print, they created music and poetry and solved math problems. In a few years, 3 of them, both students and teachers, would invent the beloved game, the Oregon Trail. Some 400 miles to the southeast, engineers at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign perfected a graphical plasma display screen for their computing system, a network that would soon connect people across the United States with communications operations we recognize today as instant messaging and screen sharing. Public intellectuals called for computing as a public utility, comparable to electricity or water. The year was 1968. When I began researching this book, dozens of vignettes like these appeared on the pages of newsletters, grant proposals, research reports, and newspaper and journal articles, and I was stunned. The people in these histories, the geography of their networks, and even the dates of their activities appeared at odds with both conventional histories of computing and powerful popular narratives. The origin stories around contemporary American digital culture, our 24/7 connected, networked Wi-Fi, smartphone, tablet, Instagram, Facebook, tweeting, thumbs up, thumbs down world, center on what I call the Silicon Valley mythology. This compelling myth tells us that once upon a time, modern computers were big, and maybe even bad, mainframes. International business machines, much more familiar as IBM, dominated the era when computers were the remote and room-sized machines of the military-industrial complex. Then around 1975, along came the California hobbyists who created personal computers and liberated us from the monolithic mainframes. They were young men in the greater San Francisco Bay Area, and they tinkered in their garages. They started companies. Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak established Apple. Bill Gates and Paul Allen developed Microsoft. Then in the 1990s, along came the internet to connect all of those personal computers and the people using them. Another round of eccentric nerds, still all young white men, Jeff Bezos, Sergey Brin, Larry Page, and Mark Zuckerberg among them, gave us Amazon, Google, Facebook, and the fiefdoms of Silicon Valley. Walter Isaacson's The Innovators expands the popular narrative of digital history to include less familiar contributors such as the 19th century mathematician Charles Babbage and the 20th century computing visionary J.C.R. Licklider. However, Isaacson, like many others, still portrays technology as the realm of engineers, experts, and inventors, or, as his subtitle declares, hackers, geniuses, and geeks. Computer technology in this mythology is far removed from everyday life until it reaches the users. Historians have certainly complicated this Silicon Valley mythology. They have pointed out the fundamental roles of federal government funding and university research in producing American computing, and they have highlighted computing's cultural origins in the Cold War and the counterculture. They have taken their investigations well beyond the Bay Area, spotlighting the contribution.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.